This one for the Negroes and for the Caucasians who care. They say they treat us like we equal. I say they treat us like we just don't care.
Hello and welcome back to GG No Re. My name is PM Magellan, okay? Leader of the Pirate Mafia, former manager of Ruling Salts, okay? Creator of TDM TV, all right? Former CPUP of Defiance, former voice of Defiance, all right? Former chief editor of Defiance, okay? That means that at one point, no one was able to put out a video under the Defiance name without my approval, right? Got some more stuff to talk about today. I know you guys have been waiting for this GG No Re to come out, and it is here, okay? First up, we got Sloop Deluxe. I said Sloop Deluxe. Sloop Deluxe, excuse me, okay? Now, Sloop Deluxe, all right? We've got Payray, the driver, okay, the helmsman, one of the more handsome helmsmen on the seas, all right, we've got Sloop A Fiasco, okay, guy isn't fucking around, he's a kickboxer, guy lifts weights, he's gonna knock you out, okay, goes by the stream name Gilly Gilly, all right, we've got Cali Lean, okay, got Mephisto, okay, Mephisto, if I'm saying it wrong, excuse me. There's many others. Okay, I don't know all the guys, but those are some of the guys I know. Okay, yeah, Seductive as well. Seductive is on there. Okay? So me and Mattress, okay, Mattress Firm, okay? Me and Mattress are at the Gold Hoarder Vault at Crook's Hollow. Okay? Now, doing our thing, you know, we're minding our own business, you know, and it almost seems like they got server merged into the server because this Reaper 5 wasn't rolling around the entire time. Who would have saw it? All right?
Yeah.
So, we open the vault, crack it open, you know, start bringing stuff to our boat, and we notice that there's a galley coming for us. Okay? Now, on this galley is Cali Lean. Okay, now he's not playing with all of the Sloop Deluxe members. He seems to be playing with some other people. Okay? So Mattress is like, we gotta go. It's time to go. We have to go. Like, okay. So we get what we can on. We get the chest of tributes on. We take off. You know, and Cali goes for the board. Cali Lean goes for the board. Mattress absolutely tears this guy's fucking head off. Okay, and I think Pirate Mafia lucked out here. Okay, I think that if he was sailing with three more Sloop Deluxe members, I think we probably would have got robbed here. You know, he hits an absolutely gorgeous chain shot, and I'm lucky Mattress was there because I was picking up the sail. Okay, if Mattress wasn't watching that ladder, they would have got us, you know? But we lucked out, you know, and we were able to get away with the treasure. You know, it's not all the time we run into a streamer or a big-time NAL player, but shout out to Sloop Deluxe. They're one of my favorite teams in the NAL. I don't know all the teams. I definitely know those guys, though. Those guys are not fucking around at all, all right? Moving on. All right, so next up, we've got Derek Chauvin. Okay, now, most of you might know who this is, and some of you don't, okay? So for those of you that don't, this is the cop from Minnesota that killed George Floyd. Okay, George Floyd was in a local corner store. You know, he was definitely appeared to be intoxicated, you know, something happens and he finds himself outside and he's being restrained by an officer. Hey, that officer was Derek Chauvin. Okay, Chauvin has spent the last year, all right, sleeping in a jail cell, you know, probably in protective custody, okay? He's not GP, we know this. He probably would have got killed if he was in GP, all right? And, you know, the trial was going on, you know, the prosecution almost fucked it up, bringing in some late evidence, all right? And it was going back and forth. The defense tried getting the case to be called a mistrial, and justice has prevailed. Chauvin is guilty and will be sentenced here in a few months, probably in a few weeks, whenever it is. You know, let me tell you guys something about jury duty. Okay, now I don't know the specifics of what they're paying in Minnesota, which is where this happened, you know, Dakota County. Okay, I lived in Minnesota for a little bit. You know, my mom moved me there when I was 11, and I spent from 11 to 16 in the suburb of West St. Paul. Okay, it's had a major effect on how I talk. It was, you know, I was just a Chicago city boy, and either you fit in or you're an outcast. So this happened in Dakota County, and let me tell you something about jury duty, okay? Like, they're paying like $16 a day or something like that in Illinois. You know, so if I get called for jury duty, motherfucker, you're guilty. Okay, like, if you wasn't guilty, you wouldn't be in the fucking courtroom. All right, like, guilty, period. I'm going home, I'm taking my $16. Thank you for wasting my fucking day. Chauvin, guilty. That's it. That's a GG, no re. Buddy, this is a demerit for not pleading guilty. Okay, you killed that man in the street. That's a demerit. All right. Another demerit for your lawyer trying to call a mistrial, all right? That is a demerit. That's two demerits, okay? Spend the rest of your life in jail. Demerit. GG no re, okay? Next up, we've got the champions of the NAL, okay? We've got the generals of the NAL. I am talking about QRF, the quick reaction force. All right. Now on QRF, we've got Lanky Tentacles, right? We've got Tartee. Okay. We've got Trick, and we've got Unusual Rabbit. Okay. Unusual Rabbit and Tartee are back by the helm. Trick and Lanky are up front, okay? They just robbed someone for a Ford of Fortune, all right? Someone is camping Reaper's hideout, okay? Misses one shot, lands the second. Two mega barrels go off. One of them's an Athena mega barrel. The other one's a normal mega barrel. I have never survived two mega barrels going off. Keep in mind, this is right after a massive update, so the damage might have been nerfed. Okay, but I have never survived two mega barrels going off. Okay, this is two people dead. Keep in mind, Tartee and Rabbit are fighting someone that boarded them once Lanky and Trick are dead. How they kill this one dude and save the boat after two mega barrels go off, I can't even comprehend the level of teamwork and the bucket canceling that went on in that situation. To me, it seems like there may have been something weird going on. Maybe, maybe not. But they do save it. In fact, Lanky comes back, throws down a bucket, maybe a patch, and goes and boards the Brigantine that was probably tucked. They probably had one of the tuckers there. Boards the Brigantine, kills them, starts trolling the guy, and you know they fix the galleon, patch it up, throw new paint on it, and the galleon's good as new. They sell all the treasure. How they survive this situation is absolutely the craziest recovery I've seen in an extremely long time. This is insane. Massive shout out to QRF for crazy teamwork and pulling that together. Like, they should have lost everything right there. Like, that guy shouldn't have even had to board. They should have lost everything. And how they got out of that, I really do not know. But they did. You know, they're QRF. They're some of the best on the seas, all right? Shout out to QRF. I have permission to use their footage. Okay. Shout out Lanky. Shout out all those guys, man. Glad to see you guys are back and enjoying the game. All right, first and foremost, this is one demerit for having powder on your boat. Okay? Actually, it's two demerits for having two powders on your boat. Okay? No powder on the vessel. All right? Next up. Okay? Now, if you're still tuned in, I want you to hit that subscribe button. Okay? If you're tuned in until this very moment in time, if you are sharing your time with me, I want you to hit that sub button, okay? Hit the like button, okay? Turn on those notifications, all right? I'm bringing you the hottest content on the seas. Hey, this is the hottest information there is. Only truth and factual information that comes from my channel, all right? Now, next up, you got your boy Gypsy Crusader. Okay, the kickboxer. Guy that got kicked out of the kickboxing school for being racist. Okay? He has caught a felony charge, all right, for possession of a firearm as a felon. Two firearms, all right? One of them was an unassembled shotgun. I'm not exactly sure what the other one was, but came from New Jersey down to Florida. Okay, was apparently minding his own business, but still doing the Omegle thing. All right. And somehow he must have showed the weapon on Omegle or something. Like, something happened. And he's probably going to do time here. You know, like, they're like Gypsy Crusader. He's not exactly a model citizen, okay? The thing with him is, most people that are going to watch this video are easily manipulated mentally by someone like Gypsy Crusader, okay? And that's the truth. I know you guys aren't going to agree with me, and I don't really care. But it's the truth, okay? The truth is he's a drug dealer, right? He got kicked out of kickboxing school, right? He's a racist, right? He's a felon, right? He's gonna do time, okay? It's a GG no re. I don't see this guy fucking opening a fucking community, fucking a community boys and girls club and fucking holding an art class. Okay, this guy's on Omegle being a fucking racist. All right, he's gonna do fucking time. Okay, GG no re. All right, that's one demerit. Okay, for being a racist. Okay, it's another demerit for being a felon. All right, the third demerit for all the bullshit you pull on Omegle. All right, that's three demerits, buddy. GG no re. And last but not least, we've got the adventure bot himself, Alec Tar, okay, AG Gaming, whatever you want to call the guy, all right? Now, in the last episode, we spoke about him juicing the Glitter Beard achievement, accommodation, right? He opened up the vault for a bunch of people. Let him in. Like, it was nothing. You know, this is to commemorate someone's death. He still doesn't get that. He's still mad. Hey, listen to what Alec Tarr has to say.
Apparently, I hurt some feelings. Like, even some streamers, like, screenshot certain parts that I say because they're so triggered about it. But, like, as I said, for me, it's content. If it was a memorial, don't put freaking accommodations bound to it or cosmetics. It's that simple, really. Like, right? And, yeah, I was kind of triggered about it, and I gave that Glitterbeard thing for 200-300 people. 200-300 people. I don't know exactly how many, but a lot of people. That's exactly what I did, and then I got kicked for out of partnership for exploitation, for personal gain. Like, it was not even personal gain, because I was, like, sitting there for 6 hours. I don't even want to be part of the partnership anymore. Even if I had a chance to get it back, I don't want it. I don't want to be part of it. I'm still gonna play the game and all that, but yeah, the community support, nor the project managers of Sea of Thieves, I think they do a very poor job, especially when it comes to communication.
So, he drops off one piece of treasure at Reaper's hideout, okay? Keep in mind this guy's solo, alright? He could have easily stopped and sold what he had. But he has this obsession with stacking treasure. I don't stack treasure. People that play with me know I don't play that shit. We're fucking selling it all. We're fucking, you know, after we sell it, we're taking a piss. We're grabbing a drink. We're, you know, getting a little bit of food. We're doing whatever we got to do to go into the next situation absolutely ready to fucking rock and roll. Okay? This dude decides to go for someone. I think they're at lookout point maybe or something, and finds himself in a pretty fucked situation. All right, gets one balled. Okay, now he's just kind of like bucketing for his life. All right, this is Glitterbeard's revenge, bro, is what this is. Okay, this man was loved by many, Alec Tarr. You need to put some respect on his name. Okay? If something were to happen to you and there was an in-game achievement for you, or an in-game trial, or an in-game Easter egg, you wouldn't want people fucking disrespecting it, dude. Grow the fuck up. You lost your fucking partnership. It's over now. Now you're just like some fucking nerd that fucking stacks treasure and claims to be the best gold hoarder of all time. You know what happened to you, dude? The curse of the gold hoarder, the greed of the gold hoarder has consumed you. And now you don't know what just basic logic is. You just don't. That curse is forever inside of you. Will consume you forever. As long as you set sail, that greed will never leave you. Alright? GG no re. Hey, you lost your shit, right? Lost your grade 5, right? And then hopped on Apex, right? Apex Legends, right? You went from being a pirate legend to an Apex legend, okay? It's a GG no re. Alright, that's one demerit. Alright? For not selling all the treasure. Okay? It's another demerit for forsaking the name of Glitterbeard. Yeah, it's two demerits. Three demerits for continuing to bring up the bullshit. Bro, you lost your partnership. It's over. Okay? It's three demerits. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Magellan. If you enjoyed this content, make sure you drop a sub. Okay? Hit that like button. All right? And thank you for tuning in. You know, I appreciate it. Until next time, this is GG No Re.
Made this one for the Negroes and for the Caucasians who care. They say they treat us like we equal. I say they treat us like we just don't care.